We've been sending Paul around Australia just to get to know a little bit of the locals, and one of the locals here that he needed to meet, he needed to get to know, were the very famous Irwins.
So here's the thing. In New Zealand, you can pretty much go anywhere. You can go through the bush, you can do anything at all, and you might see some pretty ugly-looking creatures, but none of them will kill you. Whereas here, even in my garden in Balmain...
Crikey!
Robert, I'm a 51-year-old man. You mustn't frighten me like that. The Irwin family don't need an introduction. Robert and Bindi grew up in front of our eyes. Does it look to you like he might be starting to constrict, Robert?
Can you still breathe?
I can still breathe.
You're fine.
No worries there. No worries in that department. This is not the leisurely stroll I was promised. Robert Irwin is taking me on a tour. Now, a hunt around Australia. What actually are we looking for, Robert?
Well, I don't know if I should tell you. I think I found one.
Robert, what have you got there?
This is a water dragon. Isn't he beautiful? He's so cute.
It's eye of the beholder stuff, really. Is he actually beautiful?
I think he is. So this guy, he's actually a male water dragon. You can tell because on his chest, see he's got
red.
Yeah, red on his chest. That's how you can tell that he's a male. So what you need to do is when you catch them, you can't actually squeeze too hard around their neck because...
Their head will come off.
Yeah, of course, they might get a little bit, you know...
Iffy.
Yeah, iffy. Yeah. So.
I've always been told, Robert, that if they're brightly coloured, they'll bite you and kill you. Is that true?
No, not a lot, but you still have to be careful.
So how about if I put it on the ground, if I put it on the ground, what will happen? Will it run straight away, do you think?
Yeah, probably.
Okay.
Unless it likes you.
You crouch down with me.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a funny feeling it might like both of us.
It might. Oh, no.
But not gone. That much. he's pretty cute. I think it's a he. There are around 1,200 animals at the Australia Zoo, which opened in 1970. This is Bindi's favourite, an echidna.
What I'd really like you to do is take your shoes and socks off. Can you please do that for me?
Why would I do that?
What's going to happen right now is I'm going to put this delicious substance on your toes. Are you ready? Now, tell me, what does that feel like? Isn't it?
It feels very bizarre. Oh no, it feels extremely unpleasant.
Oh, isn't it beautiful? Echidnas are really special animals. They're monotremes, which means that they're egg-laying mammals. And there's only two monotremes in the world.
One See how my face has gone funny? Because this feels weird.
Isn't it amazing?
It's weird. Terry, the kids are fantastic.
Yeah,
you must be so proud of them.
My pride and joy, absolutely. Having that genetic input that Steve had given them, they're just born wildlife warriors and enthusiastic about everything.
They are unmistakably your children.
Mm.
When you ask them the smallest question, they enthusiastically give you the longest answer.
Isn't that
fantastic?
And I think being passionate about what you do is the greatest gift you can give your kids.
And it takes a hunk of enthusiasm to get into there with those American alligators. Thankfully, they're not crocs, though I suspect that day isn't too far off in the future. That is very cool, Robert.
I know.
Very, very cool.
I'm so lucky.
I think you're probably the only boy in the world who does this, you know?
Probably.
Do you sometimes, when you're in there doing that, do you think Dad would be really proud of me?
Definitely. And all the conservation and wildlife work that we do, it's really like carrying on in our dad's footsteps. So, yeah.
Woohoo! What a gorgeous family.
I've got to tell you, they are a gorgeous family.
Mm.
You know, and those kids, they are brilliant.
And
genuinely enthusiastic.
Yeah. And how much, I mean, listening to Robert there at the beginning when he was explaining the lizard to you was just a spitting image of his dad in his mannerisms and in his inflections.
And the great thing, because we spent quite a bit of time at Australia Zoo, and as we were walking around from one location to another and they were showing me around, you know, all the tourists that were there, the people watching, they stopped and they thought, God, because the most interesting animals that are there are the Irwins.
Yeah.
And they stopped and wanted autographs and things. And the kids, just the way they handle everything, it's fantastic actually to watch. And the fact that they do appear to be just brilliant kids as well.
Mm.
So yeah, it's hard to be when you've grown up under a spotlight
exactly.
like that.
Exactly. Hats off to Terry.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely hats off to her.
Mm.
And those snakes, God, they're just...